Remember I said earlier that if we have the equation of the probability density function, we can use calculus to find the area under the curve between any two values, or between negative infinity and any value. Mathematicians have put these values in a table. Here's the top of this table. It gives you a little diagram saying that when we have the z-score, the values in this table tell us the proportion less than that z-score in the standard normal curve. So this table is for the standard normal distribution, and remember that's when the mean is 0 and the standard deviation is 1. This way, after standardizing any normal distribution, in other words, after calculating the z-scores for the values that we're interested in, we can use this table to approximate the proportion less than that particular z-score. Here, the tenths place runs vertically and the hundredths place runs horizontally. So if we have a z-score of, say, negative 2.75, remember that would then be less than the mean. Negative 2.7 is here and 0.05 is here. So if we follow over, these cells meet at 0.003. So the proportion less than negative 2.75 is 0.003, or 0.3%. So again, that's the probability that we get less than negative 2.75. And that's the proportion of objects in the sample that have a score less than negative 2.75. There's a link to the Z table that we shared. And so use that link when you use the Z table, which you're going to use in the next quiz.